All right, howdy y'all. This is Josh at FirstGenOffroad.com, and today we're going to be doing a video that I've wanted to do for a long time and just have honestly been a little bit nervous about doing it. But I'll tell you, ever since I got my bumper, which I love, I had to cut away a little bit of the splash guard here, and when I did that, it exposed my air intake right here. And so any dust that my tires kicked up, any mud, any water, just dry, I was nervous to even drive through a puddle. I didn't want to drive it when it was raining. I was afraid that I was getting too much water sucked up into my air intake. And so that kind of gave me an excuse and kind of lit the fire under my behind to get this snorkel installed. So today we're going to install the snorkel. They don't actually make one for the Sequoia, so I had to borrow one from a Land Cruiser. I have it for sale on the website, firstgenoffroad.com. I'll put a link in the description below, but I'll give you a step-by-step guide on how to do this, and I'll show you how it looks at the end. Do me a favor, like this video, and tell me what you want to see. I like where I'm headed, but if there's some other mod you want to see, or if there's another vehicle that you want to see, please put that in the comments. We'll talk about that. And let me know what vehicle you drive. I'm looking to start another series of modifications. I want to know what you guys are interested in. So comment below, subscribe, like, and again, if you wanted to purchase this, just go to my website and do it. I'm also going to make a template for you Sequoia guys, so hopefully you'll have something that works for you. This snorkel comes with a template, but it's for a Land Cruiser, so you can't use it on your Sequoia. It's 102 degrees right now, so I'm a little bit hot, but I'm still happy to be out here.
Get the wheel off, and there are a handful of bolts that keep on this splash guard, so we're going to go through here and just kind of remove every one. Then we'll pull out all the little bracket clips. There's the air intake right there. And then if you come around, you can see the antenna, but this antenna has to come out because the snorkel is going to cover the hole. And the best way that I found to do this was to use my little pry bar and carefully just kind of bang it around. This is the bottom of the whole antenna motor mount, and I'm going to unbolt this and just try and pull the whole thing out.
Don't forget this bike.
Alright, so I got the splash guard out of the way. I got the antenna mount out of the way and it's just hanging here. So now what I want to do is just tape off this section. I want to be able to draw on this and mark it up. So we'll just, and also when I start to drill, you want to have tape in place because it helps to prevent chipping. And so what I'm doing now is you can see the air intake right here. So it's about right here. So this is gonna fit into about right there, of course under the fender, and then it's gonna come out to about right here. Understand that the hole is gonna be about maybe here, here. So in this area is kind of where I wanna be. So you wanna make sure that you can open the door and not interfere, so that looks good. And it needs to look pretty straight. I'm gonna bring it back a little bit. So now I think I have it where I think I want it. Let me just quadruple check. And I'm just gonna draw. The smaller hole, the outside of this is about the same size as the hole that we'll need to drill. So I'm gonna trace this out. And just make sure that it more or less lines up with the air intake and the new hole that I'm about to drill in the side of my truck. So now I'm gonna try to find the center of this hole by measuring. This is a 4.5 inch hole, or 2.25 inches there. 2.25 inches there. 2.25 inches there. That is about the center of our hole. Before I drill, I want to look at it one more time. I think this is going to be great. So the instructions call for a 4.5 inch hole saw, so that's what I'm using. And I'm going to, it's got this, it's got its own little starter pilot hole that I'll just line up with little X, that little mark that I made. What I'm gonna do is use some tallow, and I think I've used this before on videos, and this is rendered lamb fat. So tallow works great for this. Tallow works great for this kind of stuff because it sticks on it forever. But you could use anything. You could use motor oil or olive oil or coconut oil or whatever you want. But I like tallow. Here we go. So there's the hole. Oof. Okay, so I'm somewhat recovered after that hole. That was intense. That drilling that hole was intense, y'all. There's 5 bolts that bolt into the backside of this snorkel. This is it, right? You're supposed to Loctite it, and here it calls for blue Loctite. So this is the bolt that's farthest from my pivot point. So when I angle it up and down, this bolt's going to move the most. So I absolutely have to get this one right. I'm not even gonna worry about these other 4 right now. I'm gonna put this in the hole and just make sure that I've pivoted it properly. And I'm gonna put a little bit of grease on the end of this bolt so when I push it against the tape, it'll leave a mark, and that's where I'll know the drill. And then once I've got that done, then I'll feel better about drilling the rest of the holes. So the instructions ask you to drill
a 5/8 inch hole. I'm gonna try and get away with only drilling a 1/2 inch hole. So now I have the next one with a little grease on it, and I'll just go down the line. So insert this into our new hole, insert this into the big hole. So we'll drill our new hole right there. So now we have all of our holes drilled, and now we have to clean up these edges and paint them so they don't rust. What I'm gonna do is just about try and peel away about 1/4 inch around each one of these holes. So now we need to smooth down these edges. So I'm gonna take a bastard file and just go to town here for a few minutes. So the next step is to connect this air intake to our hole that we drilled under our fender, right? So
And we do that by using this little connector piece. As you can see, it's gonna be a pretty tight squeeze. I don't know if you guys can appreciate that, but there's not a lot of room. The higher we go, the more tapered that fender is, so it may not fit completely. What we're gonna need to do is make two cuts. One is cut this right about here, and then the other cut is I'm gonna cut about maybe an inch or so off the edge of this. Fit here. That's where the air intake is, and then it snakes up to right here. But what I want is for this to kind of meet up around the rim of this hole. So I'm just going to make a mark from here to there and shave that off. So next we want to take out our air filter and air box. So I wanted to take this air handler out because I wanted to show you guys. This is going to end up squeezing into here. But the thing is that it's too thin. It doesn't make a good connection. I'll show you how we remedy that. Remember that little or 3/4 inch piece we cut off of here? We're gonna use this now to insulate our connection. Mark is right there. Schoolgirl sweetie with a classic kind of sassy little skirts climbing way up her knee. There was three young ladies in a school gym and locker when I noticed they was looking at me. I was a high school loser, never made it with a lady till the boss told me something I missed. What we'll end up doing is using a silicone glue and gluing this in. And then what that'll mean is that we can squeeze this in with a little tighter. And be able to silicone glue that in as well. The other thing I want to do, that little mark we made, you want to shave it down. So before we glue this in, I want to clean it up with just acetone. All right, so what I'm gonna use for this is just some weatherproof silicone seal clear.
looks like our silicone seal is dried. And so now it's time to test fit it, see how we do. Squeeze in right here. And that looks about right. And then we'll force it up this way. About right there. All right, so we have one part of our air intake here, and that's in place. And then the other part is where it needs to be here. Before we bolt this thing up, the directions call for blue Loctite. So that's what we'll do. And it's 100 degrees out here, and this stuff is kind of getting messy. Let's see. All right, so I've got this seam caulked on both sides, and this is going to go through here, and it's going to meet on the other side with my rubber air intake, my new piece. And so I want to caulk the edge here, and I'm thinking the best way to do that is to go around now, just go ahead and put a bead of caulk there, slip it through, and slip it into my new air intake. So there's my new air intake, the dog legs there. So now we'll just put a bead of caulk, disconnected and facing up right now. And we'll just add a good layer of caulk all the way around.
I want it to be a thick layer, because it's got to be, not a big gap, but it's got to be a gap to fill.
All right, let's see if I can get this to fit without too much trouble here. Without smearing the caulk around anywhere. So now, we'll just try to slide that into our new air intake. Make sure we're all lined up here. And that actually looks pretty and feels pretty good. Okay, good. So now for the test fit. So it wants to push out over here. So what I'm gonna probably end up doing is bolting on this bolt first and probably that one too, making sure that the connection is good, and then bending it over and bolting on these last three bolts on that side. But before I even do that, I wanna make sure that there's a nice bead of caulk around here to make sure that it's watertight. I've got this in place. Now we're off a little bit there, so I need to bend it and bolt it in over there. And I'll show you kind of where we are. A bolt up there. There's one there. So there's one that's unbolted right there. There's the one that I just bolted in, and then there's one more right there, so we'll just bolt those using the hardware that was provided with the kit. Put the last two bolts on, and once everything's in place, then we can start to tighten everything down. What I'm trying to do is just tighten down all the bolts kind of evenly at this point, so it just draws this snorkel in nice and even and doesn't put, even though it may be temporary, any undue pressure on this fender. So we've got it in place there, and I think it fits. And so now we have these two rings. And so now we can just put a healthy bead of caulk around that. So we've got our hose clamp in place there, with a bead of caulk around it, and now we gotta put our hose clamp there, and we'll put the hose clamp on and also put a healthy bead of caulk there as well.
So air handler back in, so we can close the hood now.
Now we need to put the star on the Christmas tree there.
So a couple things to notice about this. One is that it's got these little grooves here, and if it's raining, like if you're driving through a hurricane, you're sucking in a ton of water, well some of that water is going to come out of these grooves. And if any water does make it into the air box, there's that drain hole that I showed you that it can sort of drain out of, but you would have to be driving a long time and a lot of rain for that to be the case. And if you were, then what I would do is just unbolt this, twist it around, kind of like so, tighten it back up, and there you go. So the next question is what to do with the antenna. So when your options are to just nix the old one and just run without an antenna, or you can go through the trouble of wiring in a new antenna and putting it somewhere else on the vehicle. What I'm gonna do is just nix the motor, and then this is my antenna. You can, I don't know if you can hear it, we'll listen. Okay, but you can hear radio. I'm getting radio through this antenna, and what I've done is I've just kind of ran it up through the fender here, and I'm just gonna sort of zip tie it in. This is the heavy part, so I don't wanna cut this as my antenna, but I cut these two wires that power the motor. I just cut those and cap those, and then I'm gonna just cut this heavy motor part off and just ditch this and just run this antenna cable through the fender and zip tie it in. I just ran zip ties and zip tied the antenna. Do what you feel is best. I'm gonna stick with this for now.
Now we'll just have to put the flash guard back on, and of course I broke every single plastic tab when I was taking it off, so I went to the dealership and I got a few more of these. So you can get these for like, I mean, for what they are, it's expensive, like $1.52 a piece, but you only need, I think, six of them. And then I got these to go on the other side, and they're probably $1 a piece.
One day she said to me, "Where'd your work come from?"
All right, guys, so here's the finished product. So I like it, and I might try and get a heat gun and just heat that pillar up and kind of bend it over some to where it snugs the contour of the cab or the A pillar a little bit better, but I think it fits all right. And I think it's really gonna be useful. It's really utilitarian. I don't know that I'll ever cross a river that's deep enough to where I'll need it, but I think I like it. It's a safari snorkel. It's legit. It's the ARB one, Australian made. Really do like it. At first I thought it was gonna be a little bit obnoxious, but I think it goes well. I traced out a template, but yeah, if you order a snorkel, I'll throw the template in if you want it, but that's kind of what we're looking at there. You know, I've driven it a lot and it doesn't rattle, it doesn't shake, it doesn't vibrate, I haven't noticed any noises. And again, this will help with your truck getting cleaner, better quality air, cooler air. And of course it'll help if you plan on deep water crossing. And honestly, I just think it looks pretty cool. So next thing I'm gonna do, just as a teaser, what's in the box? Can you guys guess? Anyway, that's my next video. Subscribe and you'll get to see that one as soon as it comes out. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see y'all out there.